Oh, wow.
Hi, good morning, everybody. My name is Gabriel, Vargas.
Come on up.
All right. Most everybody wrote midterm exhibition. I ain't trying to go with that midterm. My killer exhibition. You guys will get it once I go through the thing. All right. Short introduction of myself. Like I said, my name is Gabriel. I was born in Brazil on August 20th, 1998. Amazing day for my mother. I'm a senior, class of 2016. Give it up for 2016. You know? My interests are, you know, my friends and family, watching CSI shows / movies, and listening to music.
Very interesting.
You're gonna stop looking at my transition. Alright, short agenda. Icebreaker, academic reflection, process and LTI, general exhibition, learning goals, and my project. Alright, icebreaker. I'm pretty sure you guys did this with Anna. It was annoying, but this is what I came up with. Alright, so you guys can go to your, everybody has a phone, right? Make sure everybody has a phone.
Yes.
Okay.
I don't.
Go to your text message, write this number on top, text this name, and then I want you to answer how does crime affect the way you live in your community?
Okay? Short and simple.
I gave y'all a story.
Can you read some of the
I'm driving, if you are right.
Good morning, just keep on reading.
We got cops to help.
What?
You can also scroll down.
Yeah, hold
on. My bad, I got it.
I saw police yesterday. Okay. Crime sucks. Everybody should have a dog and a gun to stop the crime. There's no crime in New York.
That's not accepted. Not true.
My brother got robbed twice in the last month. So it's pretty sure it ain't true.
That's why I don't want to.
I think we have enough answers for now.
Yeah,
these two presents are not
like somebody didn't notice mine.
I noticed it. Feel the burn.
That was you?
No.
And I also
know. That was Salvo.
I fucking hate Bernie Sanders.
Alright, I think it's four guys are good. Alright. That's the I work at the municipal prosecutor's office at 31 Green Street. I work from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. I work with lawyers all day, so the thing is, I sit in court from 9 to 3. I have everybody spot the criminals that I have for that day. I have their files. I look at CCHs. CCHs are their profiles, what they done, what they didn't do. Sometimes I sit through trials from 10 a.m. to 3 until I leave. It's very interesting to see what people do and what, but sometimes you just get bored out of your mind and fall asleep. I can't because the judge looking straight at me, so I really can't fall asleep. So. No. Alright, then reflection, my strength. Great listening skills, organized, focus, and fast learning. That's because I work I have to have these skills, because if I don't, they kick me out of the court. Like, they really tell you to get up and get out. So I have to listen to the judge, I have to be organized with all my files, I have to focus on what the lawyer is telling me, what the judge is telling me. I have to be a really, really fast learner. Because if you're slow in the court, you're out. Growth areas, public speaking. Right now, I am nervous as heck. You guys can tell some.
Probably.
So, man, let me come to me, man. Time management and procrastination. Oh, man. I did this thing in 3 days. I had a month to do it. And missed something else.
You ain't the only one.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure. Alright, so my post-secondary plan. If I don't become a homicide detective, I'm going to become a SWAT. SWAT, it ain't that glamorous that this seems out to be in a movie. High school diploma, you need one, and whatever degree you get. You need a degree in law enforcement or any related field. Experience, you need 3 years to be a cop or military experience. I ain't going for this, I ain't trying that early. I'm going over here, trying to be a cop. So, key skills, you have to be very fit, stamina, at least 21, US citizen, computer skills, domestic violence or assault conviction. None of that. And the salary is pretty low, but you know, $56,810. If you have a wife, she makes more money than you, it's all good.
Very sure.
She wants your ass. Alright, colleges. You can go to become a SWAT. University for Florida State and Louisville. Florida State, you can say it's a party state, but it's one of the best law enforcement schools in the country. Cuny University, I chose because it's really close, it's like a half hour drive from here. And Louisville, the mascot is just nice, I just chose it because it came up on Google. Alright, so this semester, I'm not the brightest person in the room, I'm not the brightest person in the school, but I really do try my best. I'm here, I do all the work I have to do. Cusick tries to fail me, but you know.
You ain't the only one.
I know. And
they don't want us to pass this missing
thing. Exactly. Oops, I'll go back. Alright, so my resume.
Question?
I guess not. This resume I did last year in my junior class, with my English class. It was part of my grade, so bear with me some things for here and that related to now. I kind of switched them. So, seeing a job as a homicide detective. This, you don't become this until probably 10 years in law enforcement. You have to become a cop first, and then you get promoted to become a detective. Personal skills, I'm a hard worker. I learn really fast. I'm responsible team player and liable for any task that comes my way. Very true. And I was told that by a lawyer. Lawyer told me that. So my education, high school diploma is pending. I expected June 26th, which I will get. But you know, it's just all right. So related experience, babysit my siblings. I told you I did this last year. It wasn't paid for this.
So cute.
Thank you.
Here we
go. Working construction in the summer, wallpaper, compound, electricity, painting, cleaning homes. It's very, very, very true. And here are some references. My junior teacher, my English teacher, Ms. Rubinetti, and Ms. Summy. Ms. Summy? Yeah. Alright, so a couple letters.
You said Boston.
Again, junior year. Miss Murray, I don't know who the heck Miss Murray was. Miss Ruben Junior. So it's just a basic cover letter. I write a club interest proposition at homicide detective. This talks about what I do and what I'm really good at. Here's my contact number. So, you know.
That's
pretty
much, right?
Thank you.
That's tough.
Thank you. All right, my experience in my shadow day / interview day. Most amazing day ever. We got there. I was late because I thought it was. I really thought it was somewhere else. I got there half an hour late. They were all waiting for me. It wasn't my fault. It really wasn't my fault. So we got there. Miss Ivory, she should have been here. I guess she called out because everybody was being absent from the site. So she said she couldn't be here today. But we got there, she told me I was in there are part 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's all the courts. She said part 5, everybody fights for it because it's the drug bust, it's all the trials, the abuse, all that stuff. Where's Bradley? Dude got mad because he didn't get part 5, and she got 5. So I got part 5, I'm there every Wednesday. So my first Wednesday, I got there, and got signed in part 5. Which was, you know, the court for child support, drug bust, you know, all that stuff. So this part is a little brief presentation of what I do. I work with files, I work with CCHs, I run around every single day. I run around for I need to get this, I need files, I need paper, I need this. That's, I'm the go-to guy for that. So, yeah. Okay, so, my passion. So I really want to be home site detective. It's like it's a really amazing passion. So I'm gonna ask you guys, whoever got robbed, raise your hand. Whoever got robbed. So the steps I'm gonna take. Whoever got robbed and then told the cop, oh I got robbed, and they said we'll check up with you with the detective. Whoever heard that. You guys ever heard that? Exactly. So, don't you get mad when you get robbed and the cops don't do anything about it? If your phone get robbed, your book got robbed? This is what I'm talking about right here, step 8.
Hey, Oscar.
Yeah!
So this is the step 8 I'm talking about. The cops should look at the criminal history of the people who have robbed you. They really should look into that. Like, isn't it the worst thing ever when you get robbed and the cops say, oh, we're gonna look into it. You hear from us in a week. You never hear from them. Isn't that kind of annoying? Exactly. So instead of taking other people, the cops that they should investigate, that should go in more into detail, and more into people who robbed you. That's the thing I want to get into. All right, problem. Understanding why people commit violent crimes in New York. Just give me some example. Why do you think people commit crime?
Poverty.
Any things. What is it?
No money.
Revenge. Come on, freshman, give me something.
People are just trying to find a way for this.
No, alright. This is something that I wrote. Environment, the motives, and probably anger, hate issues. This, we get a lot in the court. This, for motives, people are like, oh, she broke into my house, so I killed it. Or, I swear. For anger, she threw a TV at me, so I hit her in the head with a baseball bat.
What?
Exactly. Like, these are real motives that, like, I
throw a TV
because this actual happened. Right? What happened?
I said, don't throw a TV.
Exactly. Don't throw a TV at the dude. So, like, this really happens in part 5 where I work at. Like, these are real situations that people go through, and then the judges are looking at them like, why would you hit her with a baseball bat? She threw a TV at me. So don't do this guy. So. Alright, so probably professional development for detectives on this topic. What does this mean? What this means is what can detectives do to make what they do better? So like I said, you get robbed, they know nothing about it. They should invest more into this. That's their job, right? To catch the criminals. So if they rob you, they're not really doing their job. Is that right? Thank you. All right. So learning goals. This took me a while to think of this. So my biggest difficulty in school will be time management and distractions. Because of my internship, I have to work on both of these things. Time management, because every paperwork I do has to be done on time. If I don't, they kick me out. Short and simple. Distraction, because if I don't focus on the case and pay attention on the judge, what the judge is saying, so whatever he's telling me, or write his name down, discoveries, or whatever. If I don't pay attention, he's really going to tell me to get out of court. It's serious. So, yeah, that's it. Thank you. So for example, if Chris is in the court that day, if he did something, the lawyer would tell me to go get his CCH. It's his profile, it's his issue. If he did anything wrong in the past, it's his issue. You know, it's his lookup. That's what CCH means.
Wait, you're with the city, right?
What?
You're with the city?
Yeah.
So it's like a little thing, right?
Basically.
Well, when do they pass that on to the liaison?
Oh, that's up in county. If you found guilty, that's up there. Say.
Okay, how is that going to help you be a police officer or a detective?
Okay, Ms. Crosby couldn't find me a job at Homicide Tech because it's kind of hard to move forward, you know? But this teaches me how the law works, how people get sent to jail, or what did they do, and how did a police officer handle that? Because in the courtroom, every day, there's always cops there. For example, if there's somebody on trial, the cops that gave them the ticket or whatever, they have to be there. So I learned how to deal with situations. Anybody else?
Questions? More questions?
Any? What has been your biggest challenge since you've been interning there?
Oh man, not falling asleep. No, it's a real thing, because when you sit there and the judge is talking, and like you have nothing new because the lawyer does most of the work, you know? And you just sit in there and you look at the judge and you daze. And then
don't
you work at a court? It just seems like they have to be like 50 pages, and the fine is like 12, size 12 or 14.
For what?
For every trial and stuff.
It depends on the trial. Like everybody has their own trial, so the packet that they give to the judge or lawyer, it's a different size. But yeah, basically.
What was the most exciting case you've ever seen?
Most exciting case, you mean the trial, just regular,
yeah, just
on the trial? It was a tenant and a landlord. I guess she was moving out the apartment, and when the landlord got there, the door was busted open, because I guess the door was locked. The door, like somebody kicked in the door, and then all the witnesses saying, oh, it wasn't me. And the judge just sits there and laughs at them, because they know one of them did it. And the tenants just say, she poked down my door, she did this and that. And then she's like, no, I didn't. I was like, yeah, you did. You poked down his door, don't lie.
You mentioned that you were assigned a Part 5 court.
Mm-hmm.
Could you describe that more, what the other numbers are? Like,
they don't call it court, but it's Part 5. What part do you have?
20.
What part do you have?
Part 2.
So every court, it's a different situation. My thing is drug bust, it's abuse, it's child support, all that stuff.
Aww.
What's yours?
It's a variety of everything, and it's like more dealing with before it gets to Part 2. So we deal with like kind of the hard stuff, and then we will pass it down.
Sounds like what do you do?
Mine is just drugs.
See, every court. So every court, it's a different situation. No, every court, these are different things.
Kids, don't do drugs. Man.
Yeah, don't do drugs, because
do
the city.
You'll
catch
drugs. I'll be speaking from experience.
What kind of
drugs? I'm saying you're my negative, right?
like to give yourself to first and work your way
out. Oh, yeah. You first, no way. Yeah, that's becoming a police officer. But I guess like the way I researched, it's the way you work. If you work, if you work really hard, you get promoted every single time. So eventually you get promoted to being a detective, and then you choose the area you want to go into. That's the thing. Did that answer your question?
Yeah, I'm just trying to think about, yeah. So is there a special school to become that kind of detective?
Yeah, no, like, well, not just your school, but the colleges, the office was Keene, like, the most one I researched, was Keene, Florida State, and Louisville.
I have a question to follow up on that. You said Florida State was one of the best schools for law enforcement. Can you say, do you know why that is? Or, like, what is it about their program?
It's basically their program. I guess they have according to all the students that went through, like, their reviews, it's the best criminal, like, justice, like, you know, like, law enforcement program in the country, I guess.
But what was the number part you were part of?
Part 5.
Is there any other parts you want to join?
Me? I don't get to choose. Like, the first day they told me where I had to go. But part 5 is amazing. Like, I never tried part 20 and part 2. I always been in part 5. Part is it never seems to amaze me. It's always surprising. Always surprising.
And what colleges have you applied to?
Don't talk to me. You can, but it's harder to find a job if you don't.
So I'm assuming that you want to do that.
I will apply. Don't worry. I will apply.
Is that part of your? Can you go back to the slide where it says his weakness?
You see this?
Oh, the growth area. It says what?
Procrastination
and time management.
Okay.
No, I'm just asking. I'm just thinking in the future, if I had a family member that was, you know, killed, God forbid, okay, and they called you, I would think, I'd say, wow, I would want this detective to kind of take care of this case in an expeditious manner.
Okay.
You follow my point?
I got you.
So if you treated my death of my family's case the way you treated applying to college,
oh my gosh.
I'm thinking, I mean, one of these freshman girls can go on a crime spree.
Okay,
I got you. Boy,
I got you. I got you.
This is mostly just games.
I got you. Get up, everybody. That was my comment.
Good question, Mr. Sapperson.
Thank you very much,
to be honest.
My name is Zach.
Bill Gates.
Am I encouraging him?
No, I can't. Bill Gates and Albert Einstein did their college.
Can we?
Can I get a picture?
Can we go into feedback, guys? Let's do feedback. Positives and then
negatives.
No, growth areas. Go ahead.
I feel like out of all the senior presentations I saw, I feel like this was the best one for me.
Okay, more feedback, guys, students, freshmen.
Right here?
No, I think.
Right here.
Yeah, brought them in.
I really feel that you're enthusiastic, but you rush a little bit. But even though you rushed, I felt that like rushing, like it fitted in what you're like, since you're doing a lawyer thing and lawyers are really like stressed out and rushing a lot, so it felt like it really fitted in your home
exhibition. Thank you. Anybody else?
Ah, oh, Jesus. I will say that I'm not in a lot of exhibitions, mm-hmm. and I'm gonna be honest, because I usually am.
Yeah.
I came here for one reason.
To make fun of it?
No. I came here because I wanted to see what that whole thing was all about. You came in all dressed up nice, whatever. I don't know much about your internship. I know your grades, I know who you are, and you're kind of like skirting around doing things. So I wanted to come in here and see what was going on. And I will tell you that I'm pleasantly surprised and also proud of you. Because although you haven't done much of anything in your post-secondary life, I will tell you that you're selling yourself short, because if you put the vigor and the passion that you're doing with this, which again, I'm thrilled with, into applying to colleges, it's probably the reason why you couldn't be in Florida State right now, the number one criminal justice program in America, blah, blah, blah. And so my message to you is, keep this going, and I apologize for everything I said about my
dad. Oh, you got it.
I'd like to say that I'm really happy that I'm not a very simple person that's obsessed with criminal justice. I like to say that people interested in the same area as me, and that's a big part of the passion for it. But I would just like to remind you that
I know. Well, I do. I yeah. Sure.
Oh, Jeff, this is me. Look, guess who just came into the school right
now? Okay, good. Thank you. Any more student feedback before we get to the grown folk?
Oh, sorry. I shouldn't have went.
No, no, you're fine. You are the all. We have marching on the school. Do you have feedback?
I thought we were going to do old grown folk first.
What did you say?
Any more feedback from students? Freshman, Anthony, you ladies, say something.
I feel like
No more students? Chris?
Thank you.
Keeson, do you want to call one of your freshmen?
No.
Yeah. Eddie. Jocelyn.
Huh? I'm not a freshman.
Eddie.
I like how you were upbeat about everything, but I feel like you were a little too upbeat because I think it was nervous. I get it.
Yeah,
everybody is.
Sure.
So, I mean, good job overall.
Thank you.
All right, great. Thank you. Miss A?
What?
Yeah, I don't see you.
You don't see me now?
I do. I see you something better.
Okay.
All right. I thought you did really well. Your voice was projected, and you were very engaging. And I loved that you said, "Oh, cops should do this." I thought that was really neat. Because I know it's easy to fall into the system, and but it's good that you said you should do this. One negative I had was, the eye contact, you were reading too much, and I thought you were speaking a bit too fast sometimes,
okay.
So I was trying to catch up to you. Otherwise you did a really good job.
Thank you.
That was tough, though.
Why did you slow now?
Alright, so I thought your overall presentation was actually really good. You had control of the room. I looked around to see everybody seemed to engage in what you were saying. You had a couple of errors on your slides. Kind of like Ms. A said, you need to slow down, which happened because you're very passionate. You're very excited, which was great because your enthusiasm was there. Your content thing, the only thing you would have had a little higher was that you're missing your personal narrative.
Yeah.
So that was one thing we had to take into consideration. I'm going to kind of piggyback on what Mr. Sapperson was saying. You are a very, very bright kid, and I think when getting to a four-year college, I think you'll grow up a little bit. I think that that will be where you finally strive. I think you don't understand that you are a very bright, capable young man, and that you kind of fool around too much. I think that's where you need to grow up a little bit. But I think that he said, you want to be, whatever it is that you actually want to do with your life, if it is this, I think that you're going to do excellent at it because you have that drive and the intelligence to do well. It's the getting away, I think, from here and being living on a campus, and you'll kind of grow up, because I really think from just having class from this year, you are very bright, you're lazy, you don't want to take that next step to kind of do what's needed to do better on different things. But I think you're, again, I think you're going to do extremely well in life. And I'm looking forward to seeing your project for in the spring.
All right, thank
you. All right, so Gabe, I loved your presentation. Your enthusiasm was just off the charts, and that's great to see, because it means that you have real passion for your, you know, what it is that you want to do in life, and your internship. Like, even though it's not exactly what you wanted to do, you made a connection, and you realize that this is part of a bigger world when it comes to criminal justice and law enforcement. And so I think that that's really awesome. What I want to see more is your project. You kind of tapped into it a little bit about what you want to do, but I wanted to hear more about like what your long-term plan is for that project and why you think it's important. So like, you got some good feedback from the audience about how they feel about their communities in terms of crime and how the police respond to things that are happening. So now I want you to take that feedback and let that drive what it is that you want to do in terms of this project and how that's going to have an impact. Because you have a real situation where you can actually improve people's lives by just taking that and running with it. The little things that were already mentioned, like just, you know, update your resume, your cover letter, so that it's applicable to, you know, what you're doing. And I think what Mr. Saperstein and Mr. Cusick said is really important. I think this is time for you to step up, because you have all of the ability, you have the smarts, you have the passion. So take those three things and start applying them. Get those applications in, like, tomorrow. That should be the number one thing you do, because you really don't have too much else to worry about, right? You don't have to do the testing requirement. You don't have to do a lot of that stuff. So you should be one of the students who's like got an acceptance letter already. You know what I mean? So yeah, so get that done. Get all those applications in. Get your letters of recommendation. Get the FAFSA done. And then just start, keep leading. Like, keep doing what you're doing and just keep improving. You're on the money.
Thank you.
Great job.